of teams right next to each other in the CAA standings. Hi, everybody. I'm Matt Janis alongside Christine Corimata. We've got Roddy Vickers back in our Newcastle studios. And Christine, this Delaware team at 13-8, 6-4 in conference play, taking on William & Mary 15-7 overall, 6-5 in the CAA. So this is an important one in terms of trying to hold serve and hold position.
Yeah, and especially the first of many home games coming up for these Hens. They need to get off to a good start.
Starting lineups in this game. First for the Tribe, as we mentioned, 8 above 500 overall, 1 north of sea level in conference play. They are led by point guard Jenna Green, 496 career assists. She's also averaging 11.5 points per game, the senior out of Clifton, Virginia. Also in the starting lineup, Nyla Pollard. She's been coming off the bench of late, but returning to the lineup. 5'9 freshman from Virginia Beach, Virginia. 4.5 points and 2 rebounds per game. The third guard, Bianca Boggs. Boggs, the leading scorer for William & Mary. The junior out of Waldorf, 17 points, 5 rebounds per game. Has scored double figures 20 times so far in 22 games this year. In the front court, Abby Rendell, one of the best shot blockers in the conference, maybe the country. She's the all-time leader both in CAA and William & Mary history. She has 3 career triple-doubles. And she's joined by Victoria Reynolds, a sophomore out of Pasadena, California, who's been a surprise scorer, 11 points and over 7 rebounds per game. Head coach of the Tribe, Ed Swanson. He is assisted by Millette Green, Lynn Ann Kukowski, Sarah Eichler, and Karen Bell. The Delaware Blue Hens, 13-8 overall, 6-4 in conference play, and the Hens have the usual starting five. Abby Gonzalez is the point guard, the sophomore out of Wexford, Pennsylvania, joined the backcourt by Bailey Cargo, 5'10 sophomore out of Greensboro, North Carolina, still near 45% on the season from three-point range. The small forward is Simone DeFries, 5'11", sophomore from Bergenfield, New Jersey. The power forward is another sophomore, Rebecca Lawrence, the Richfield, Connecticut native. And the center, Nicole Anabosi, 6-foot junior out of Gaithersburg, Maryland, averaging a double-double on the year. This will be a tough matchup, though, for her as she has to deal with the length of Abby Rendell. Head coach of the Hens, Natasha A. Dare, in her first season, assisted by Bob Clark, Sarah Jenkins, Michaela Walker, Kayla Miller, and David White. Christine, we got your full keys in the pregame show. What stands out most in terms of importance for Delaware here tonight?
Patience. I think they need to be patient on offense, give the bigs time to establish, and patience within the shot clock.
Delaware will wear the home white jerseys today with the yellow script letters across the chest that spell out Delaware. Blue numbers on the front and backs of the jerseys with the UD logo on the left and right side of the shorts. Meanwhile, William & Mary in the road green jerseys, white numbers and white letters and caps across the chest of the front that spell out William & Mary. White numbers on the backs, no nameplates, gold trim, and they have gold and white trim down the left and right side of the shorts. Delaware will move from left to right to get the game started. The opening tip comes between Nicole Anabosi and Abby Rendell, and we are set for basketball from the Bob Carpenter Center as the tip controlled to Jenna Green. And William & Mary will go to work, but the shot clock had a malfunction as it was down to 14. So 4 seconds in, we get our first issue, and they'll move it to 28.
And already, Rendell's length disrupting things for the Hens. No problem on the tip there.
Swatted that back like she was Dikembe Mutombo.
No finger wave.
Here's Rendell inside, draws a double team, kicks it right wing over to Jenna Green. Green surveys her options, puts it on the deck. Man-to-man defense for Delaware. Feed goes into the corner to Pollard. Pollard dribbles inside the arc to Rendell on the left wing. Cross-court feed over to Green. Behind the back bounce, works her way to the paint. Pull-up jumper, can't get the roll. Rendell the offensive board, her follow off the mark. And Anabosi clears the rebound for Delaware. Outlets it up to Gonzalez. Long pass forward to DeFries. Nice catch, and they'll set things up.
Already Jenna Green affecting things offensively. What a move there on offense, behind her back and up.
Delaware trying to figure out the defensive set for William and Mary as it's Cargo on the right wing and works her way towards the paint, gives it off of the baseline to Lawrence. Her short jumper, no. Rendell the rebound. That looked like either a 1-3-1 zone or a very soft switching man.
I thought it was a man.
Here's on the right wing, an open three for Pollard. That one wouldn't go. Rebound batted around, and it's DeFries grabbing the rebound. If it's man, they are not going to challenge Delaware anywhere near the perimeter.
I think it's a sagging man because they're giving all the attention to Nicole Nabosi and making Delaware prove they can shoot from the perimeter.
They are playing 10 feet off of Anabosi, 5 feet off of Lawrence. The high-low lob goes to Anabosi. Help comes on the backside, and it'll be a foul. It looked like Jenna Green undercutting Anabosi on the high-low opportunity. It'll be a possession foul. Delaware to throw it in. 8:37 left in the opening quarter.
But I like that. I like that mindset of the high and low. I think she made a great pass, and Bosa just couldn't get her hands on it.
And picking up a foul on Green in the early going doesn't hurt Delaware's cause, that's for sure. Lawrence lobs it on the right block to Anabosi, kicking it out to Cargo. Right wing triple would not go. Offensive board, Lawrence follows up. That doesn't go. Rendell the rebound. There's a lid on both rims in the early going.
Yeah, tough angle there for Rebecca. She needed to use the glass there.
Grin gives it near wing to Boggs. Boggs dribbling towards the top of the key. The Let's Go Hens chant will continue until Delaware gets on the board. Working her way inside the arc is Boggs. Boggs kicks it out to Pollard. Pollard attacking off the dribble. And a floater wouldn't go. Short off the front of the rim. Flat-footed rebound corralled by DeFries. Outlets it up to Gonzalez. Gets it right wing to Cargo. Inside to Lawrence. Back out to Cargo. Right wing triple. Got it! Bailey Cargo gets Delaware on the board. First 3-0 Hens. 2 minutes in.
Both teams getting very good looks. And Bailey Cargo, I like the mindset here. She's aggressive. She wants to get going. She shoots very well in this building.
And she was certainly calling for it. Got her feet underneath her. Rendell gets it on the right block shot. Rejected by Anabosi. Here comes Delaware the other way. Gonzalez looking to push. The opportunity not there. So she slows it up. It's a trailing Anabosi who works her way left of the lane. Banks it in high off the window. Beautiful take from Nicole Anabosi.
And that's where Anabosi has the advantage on Rendell. If she could pull her out and take her to the rim, she could draw some fouls or beat her on the dribble drive.
And then a hesitation try from Victoria Reynolds. She walked to give the ball right back to Delaware.
This is a great start for the Hens. Even early on where they were missing those shots, they're getting every look they want right now and picking apart the defense.
Nari Garner in. She had been starting of late. Comes off the bench today. And sitting down is Pollard. Here comes Delaware the other direction, breaking some pressure. They find Lawrence. Right corner jumper would not go. And a rebound corralled by the point guard, Jenna Green. Green brings it up for herself. One on three. Still works her way to the paint. Kicks it out to Garner. Quick shot wouldn't go. Offensive board. Reynolds doesn't follow. Instead kicks it out to Green for a reset. Green attacking off a crossover move. Threw it off the foot of Anabosi. A kick save and a butte to prevent a layup. And it'll be William and Mary throwing it in baseline right.
Yeah, Green second-guessing herself there. She wanted to take that shot. She should have taken that pull-up jump shot, second-guessing with the bad pass.
You don't see indecision from her very often. Garner gets the inbound foul line left, works her way to the elbow, kicks it top of the circle to Green, and Green will call out an offensive set. Bounce pass, right wing to Garner. Garner, jab step, lob inside, right block. It goes to Reynolds. Reynolds stripped by Anabosi, got it back. Push shot, can't get the roll. Gonzalez the rebound. Here comes Abby Gonzalez the other way, sprinting into the forecourt, working her way to the right wing and slowing things up.
Yeah, one thing I noticed in the last couple offensive sets, Rebecca Lawrence very flat on her shot. She needs to get more arc on that.
Anabosi trying to split a double, got fouled on her way to the basket. Garner on the reach in, and it'll be Delaware ball. Second team foul on William and Mary, the first on Nari Garner.
I like the attack mode, though, of Nicole Anabosi. She's looking to go to the rim.
So a substitution in here for William and Mary. Gabby Rogers checking in. The inbound will go to DeFries in the far corner. She gets it in on the right block to Anabosi, who is bumped and fouled. And almost immediately, Gabby Rogers picking up the personal. That'll be her first, team's third.
Well, nothing like coming in a game and making something happen.
Rogers, a freshman out of Dallas, Texas. Product of Bishop Lynch High School. Now a foul away for the ball. And the officials will confer. No call immediately. It is on William and Mary. So four team fouls already. Rogers certainly getting her money's worth. She's played about 10 seconds. She's picked up two fouls, and she'll have to sit down.
This couldn't have gone any better for the Hens. Not only are they being aggressive, getting every shot they want, now every foul the rest of the quarter from William and Mary will result in free throws.
Bailey Eichner will replace Rogers, who goes to the sideline with the two fouls. Ed Swanson having a conversation about the way the game is being called. Whatever happened, certainly there was some contact. It drew blood on poor Rebecca Lawrence as she goes over to Melanie Johnson, the athletic trainer for Delaware, to get attended to.
Yeah, so this becomes kind of like a free timeout for both teams in a way.
Although right now it is a race not only to get the bleeding stop, but to get the blood off the jersey for poor Rebecca to see if she can stay in the game.
Well, Mel's the best. She'll get it done.
It is funny to watch these athletic trainers have to work within the time constraints, and great job, as usual, by Mel to keep Lawrence in the game.
Clutch, clutch. She's a gamer.
That's why they wear that one glove over there sometimes. The inbound will come from Cargo, baseline right. 5-0 and 6:11 to go in the opening quarter. Out to Gonzalez, top of the key, right to Lawrence on the left wing. Hands it there to DeFreeze. Bounce pass at the foul line. Anabosio the drive. Runner wouldn't go. Rebound volleyballed around. Finally corralled in traffic by Boggs. And she spins her way out of danger. Works it across the timeline into Gonzalez and is fouled as she threw it at the rim alertly. And as a result, Bianca Boggs will head to the stripe for a pair.
Yeah, Boggs, I think, kind of getting away with one there. I thought she was a little bit out of control and probably a good no call, but.
Exactly. That's a great point. You don't see the no call very often, any type of contact, and immediately that whistle sounds. First free throw for Boggs is good. And William Mary finally on the board. It took him 4:07. It's 5-1.
Yeah, and it's not that there wasn't contact, but she was out of control as the offensive player.
Gonzalez couldn't get in position to take a true charge, but as you just mentioned, there is a third option. Boggs makes the second free throw, 5-2, and more full court pressure from William and Mary. Kind of a dummy press. Looks like almost looking to buy some time before Delaware gets into its offense, which they do at 21 on the timer.
Now they have switched the defense now, though.
It goes zone into the corner. Cargo fires a three. It was partially blocked. Corralled under the basket by Garner. Garner outlets it up to Jenna Green. Green center of the floor. Wicks her way to the far wing. At the right elbow now. Cross-court feed left wing to Garner. Garner looking inside. Can't find Eichner. Instead goes up top to Reynolds. Swings it right wing to Green with 15 on the timer. Green gives it left wing. Open triple for Boggs. No good. And then a foul. And Abosi on the hold. Battling for position with Bailey Eichner.
That was great inside action there by William and Mary, with Bianca Boggs setting the big screen, popping up to the top of the key, getting a wide open shot. Great inside action.
5:18 left first quarter, 5-2 Delaware leads. The Hens will shoot two every foul the rest of the way in this quarter for William and Mary, so they've got to be aggressive. Tribe with it, top of the key, open jumper. Victoria Reynolds gets the roll, and it's 5-4, the first field goal of the game for William and Mary.
Yeah, a little spark. Ed Swanson with a great decision to change up the defenses here and going the zone. Now going from this dummy pressure back into the zone because they're not able to match up man-to-man right now with Delaware.
2-3 look, but they're going to try to take a high post away from Anabosi. They get it to her, though, right at the free throw line. Looks opposite corner to DeFreeze. Extra feed left wing to Gonzalez. Skip pass to the corner. Lawrence hits the jumper. Great ball movement by Delaware. They're up 7-4.
And much better arc on that shot for Rebecca Lawrence. Those first two she let go were just much flatter. She likes to kind of teardrop.
Reynolds got it. The free throw line missed a jumper. Not great defense from Delaware, but they get away with it. Gonzalez the rebound. Outlets it forward to DeFreeze. Jumper good in transition. 9-4 Delaware.
It's so imperative that Delaware get off to a good perimeter shooting start, which they have here. Everyone getting in on the action.
And looking confident with the shot as well, not shying away from it. They went over 6 minutes in the fourth quarter against Northeastern without a field goal. Here a foul away from the ball will be caught against the Hens, and it'll be William and Mary ball when we return. Timeout on the floor, 4:06 left in the opening period. It's the Hens 9, William and Mary 4. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
We'll be right back. It has been an interesting start to this game. Great start for Delaware defensively in some ways. William & Mary is just one of 10 for the field, so statistically certainly so. But it feels like the Tribe have gotten some looks that they'd ordinarily knock down that they've been unable to find the range on.
Yeah, I think Delaware is disrupting them enough, though, and that's been the difference, and they're boxing out well. But Delaware taking great care of the basketball. No turnovers thus far. I hope I did not just jinx that.
The inbound will come baseline left from Garner. Garner gets it into Rendell on the right block. Turnaround jumper over Lizzie O'Leary wouldn't go. And a great rebound for Nicole Anabosio on a fantastic box out.
Yeah, not many second chance opportunities for the Tribe.
Gonzalez brings it across the timeline. Zone defense still for William & Mary. High post give to Anabosi. Got a pass that was tipped inside to O'Leary. Her shot blocked, goes high in the air. It's batted around, loose in the corner, and out of bounds off the Hens. DeFries thought a William & Mary player tipped it, is searching for an ally among the Zebras, but doesn't look like she's going to find one. I thought it actually did go off of Delaware's hand.
Yeah, I thought so too, but I like the effort.
Certainly was ready to sell it, that's for sure. Green across the midcourt stripe gives it left wing Garner. Open triple, would not go. Long rebound grab by Reynolds. Gives it off to Rendell into the corner. It goes far side of the floor to Boggs. Extra feed to Garner, who hits the triple. She's not shy about getting them up. And it's 9-7.
On those long perimeter shots, you got to get bodies on people on the perimeter. Can't just box out underneath. Got to push back out deep.
Gonzalez has it in the forecourt for UD. Lobs it right block to O'Leary. O'Leary powers up, banks it off the mark, but was fouled. Looked like it would go for an and one opportunity. Instead, two free throws coming for the freshman out of Abington, PA.
I really like that matchup, Lizzie O'Leary against Reynolds. I think she can overpower her just like she did. If she takes her time, she does a great job of putting the ball on the floor and going up off the glass.
First free throw, good. A lot of things to like about Lizzie O'Leary's game, but near the top of the list has to be the way that she can create space without picking up offensive fouls.
I think that's 1A. I think 1B is the way she runs down the floor. I love the way she sprints down the floor.
Fair point. You might even flip that in order of importance. I bet the coaching staff would. She hits both free throws. 11-7. Delaware's lead is 4. William & Mary the other way. 3 left in the opening quarter. Bounce pass near wings to Boggs. Up top to Reynolds. Reynolds gives a high post to Rendell. She was stripped. The steal. Anabosi tipped it to DeFries. Tried to thread the needle with a bounce pass. Too far out in front of Mascaro, and the turnover gives it back to William & Mary.
It was actually a little bit of a rough angle. I think they were running a little too close together. That's why I want to take those wide lanes and get that better angle, and then she could run into that pass.
Here's William & Mary the other way, trailing by 4. Green on the left wing. Bounce pass across the floor to Garner, back to Green, top of the key. Works her way to the left block. It's stuck. Feeds it up top to Reynolds. Reynolds to Green on the left wing. Green, a couple of jab steps, puts it on the deck, crossover move, works her way to the left block, along the baseline, and they're going to call a foul on O'Leary. Yeah. Ooh, it looked like O'Leary had the position, and Green stepped on the baseline. Instead, it is a foul, and that is the fourth team foul on Delaware, the first on O'Leary.
Really, what happened was Lizzie O'Leary was solid, and Green bounced off her.
Looked like a cartoon. Here's an inbound near corner. It goes to Garner. Another triple off the mark. Rebound bounces right into the bread basket of O'Leary. She gives it off to Gonzalez. Sprints her way ahead of the pack. Works her way left wing. Now gives it up to DeFries. Back to Gonzalez. Top of the circle. Lobbing it high post to Anabosi. Turn and face. Inside to DeFries. Off her fingertips out of bounds. Just a little too hot to handle from the corner of Bosa.
Yeah, it was a great pass, but you're right, just a little too much on it. That would have been a really nice play right under the rim there.
Fantastic idea, though, for sure. She was wide open. Here's William & Mary in the forecourt. Top of the circle with it, Garner. Garner into the corner, Boggs, open triple. Back rim, no, and the weak side rebound corralled by Mascaro. Justina brings it up for herself across the timeline. Works her way to the wing right side. Flips it off to Gonzalez. Left wing give to Anabosi. Corner feed to DeFries. Swing it right wing Mascaro. Extra feed to a wide open Gonzalez. Buries the triple. Abby Gonzalez puts Delaware up 7.
Abby had enough time to rotate that ball in her hands and read the label before she let that go. Good looking stroke there.
1:20 left in the first quarter. High post, Rendell, no spacing for William & Mary. Ball was tipped, but right back to her. Finds Green on the left elbow. Jumper bangs off the glass. Rebound, Anabosi. Again up to Gonzalez. Feeds it even further forward to DeFries. Layup was blocked. Rebound out of bounds off of Simone. And back to William & Mary. It'll go.
I think think Delaware's making good decisions in transition. I know there was a turnover, but what they're trying to do, I like when they're deciding to push and when they're deciding to pull the ball back out.
Decision, such an important part of this matchup. William & Mary, a team that always seems to make good ones, although struck me here in the early going. Green head fakes a three, works her way inside the arc, leaves it off for Rendell, who scoops it home off the window. Pretty little two-man game, and William & Mary's back to within five.
Yeah, William & Mary's leaders, upperclassmen, they've done that many, many times.
Gonzalez walks it across the timeline. Hens going left to right in this opening half. 39 seconds left in the quarter. Mascaro with the top of the key. Her feet tipped in the air and stolen away by William & Mary. Boggs flips it forward on the run to Green. Green stop and pop for the free throw line. Can't get the roll. And a Bosie the board, and the Hens can hold for one.
Yeah, Green wanting a foul there. I thought she got hit on the arm. And what's a weird rotation on that ball?
I don't think the officials were all the way back to see it.
Yeah.
The shot came so fast. Adebosi with 15 seconds left in the quarter. Wants to attack. Works her way to the lane. Now has it on the elbow. Across the lane. Scoops it up and gets fouled. Boy, did she work hard for that. Not a ton of contact. They are calling it tight, at least here in this opening quarter.
Yeah, Knightner really bailing her out there because I didn't think she had a good angle, and she got pushed pretty far wide to the right side. It would have been a tough shot. I think Eichner was saying she was straight up, but really bailing Delaware out.
That's her first free throw. Good for Anabosi. She'll get one more. Hens lead is 6:15-9. 9 7/10 seconds remaining in the opening period. One more free throw. Anabosi connects, and it's 16-9.
Delaware's done a really good job here. They need to get a stop.
5 seconds left to the quarter. Green across the timeline. Little hesitation, hands it off to Boggs. Boggs with 2 seconds left, back to Green. They won't get a shot off. So good decision-wise. Normally completely blanked on the game and score situation. And that's the end of the opening period. Delaware 16, William & Mary 9. Back with the second quarter. In a moment, you're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing, maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously, or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
It into the post to Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
Can't even see the score.
Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition. You can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get 6 numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Rush hour or relax hour. It's your choice. Ride more, save more, do more. Dart. Moving forward.
They broke, don't fix it. That's the story defensively right now for Delaware, holding William & Mary to just 9 first quarter points. The Tribe shooting 17% from the field, 3 of 18, 1 of 7 from deep. And, you know, Christine, I thought they got some decent looks over the first 5 minutes. Not many at all in those last 5 minutes of that opening quarter.
No, I thought Delaware's defense, you know, was great in the latter half of that first quarter, but it was the rebounding, a lot of one and dones.
7-point Delaware advantage. Hen ball to start the second quarter. Gonzalez with it on the left wing. Inside for Mascaro. Feet came a little late and stole it away. Boggs, what a pass. Ahead to Green. Pull-up jumper. Banks around and out. Rebound padded off the hands of Mascaro. Out to Green. And the Tribe will get another try. Boggs works her way right to the lane. Draws a double. Finds Rendell at the free throw line. And she hits a wide-open 15-footer. It's 16-11.
There's been some nice little games within the game here. Two-man game with William and Mary. With certain duos, and they've done it well with the pick and roll.
9:22 left, second quarter. Cargo into the corner, finding O'Leary. She'll hoist a deep two, wouldn't go. Weak side offensive rebound, Mascaro. Tua cutting O'Leary, who dropped the pass. Mascaro dove after it, but tipped it to Boggs. Boggs got a two-on-one, leads it off for Garner, who lays it in.
Yeah, some of these passes have just been too hot to handle it. There's something to be said for touch. Got to have a good touch. There's a lot more to passing than people think.
Indeed. You got to throw a catchable ball.
You got to throw a catchable ball. It's timing, it's placement, and it's touch.
Here's Gonzalez on the near wing. Finds Mascaro. Was wide open. Didn't want to take the jumper. Instead, good decision to get it inside to Adebosi. Looks opposite for Cargo. Open, triple, front rim, no. Mascaro follows on the offensive blast. Banks it in.
How many times this year have we seen Justina Mascaro not only get rebounds off the weak side, but make those baskets right when Delaware needs to stop a run?
Rendell looking for an answer. Inside, out the box. Left wing triple. Good. And it's 18-16.
Boggs, such an impressive player. Really just having a fantastic season for the Tribe.
Now, Adebosi pawed at and fouled by the aforementioned Boggs right in the center circle. About on the eye of UD there at midcourt. Simone DeFries will return. Mascaro out for Delaware. 18-16. The Hens lead has been trimmed to 2. 8:18 left second quarter.
So you're saying UD had a bird's eye view to that
one?
Oh, my goodness. Oh.
The pun's coming out early. You can tell it's your second game of the day, folks. Cargo on the near wing. Into the corner. Gonzalez open triple. Buries it. Abby Gonzalez puts the Hens up 5.
From pretty much the exact same spot that she hit the other one.
As she was calling for that ball almost the entire possession, Boggs splits a double, leaves it inside for Reynolds, who has her shot swatted to the baseline by Adebosi.
Adebosi's been so active here on the defensive end, swatting shots, boxing out, rebounding, and clearing space.
Inbound goes to Reynolds on the left block. Adebosi all over her, kicked it out to Boggs. Boggs left it inside for Garner, but too far out in front. Out of bounds, turnover, gives it back to the Hens.
Yeah, Delaware really very balanced here tonight. Their offense is cooking. Defense is making stops when they need them. It's a game of runs. William & Mary's going to go on runs, but they're doing a good job of stopping this one.
Lawrence back in for the Hens. They work it across the timeline against some pressure. Lawrence has it in the corner, straddling the arc, fires the deep two and hits. Rebecca Lawrence showing the confidence. Hens back up 7.
I love when Rebecca Lawrence shoots those long perimeter shots. She's got such a beautiful shot, and because she lets it go so high, it's very unguardable.
Rendell got an inside touch, got it swatted by Lawrence this time, and the rebound bounces out to Cargo. Cargo weaves right, now left, works her way into the forecourt. Feeds it off to DeFries. High post give to Adebosi. Head fake, looked opposite. Gonzalez open right wing 3. Air ball. And it's out of bounds as DeFries tried to save it in. That time Gonzalez rushed the shot just a tad. And DeFries felt awkwardly slow to get up. It seems to be all right.
Well, she wasn't in the same spot. She was a little bit more to the left. That's why.
And unfortunately, the shot missed a little bit
exactly.
More to the left as well.
That's just not squaring up to the rim. That's because her body was shifted a little bit to the left.
Green walks it across the timeline. Bounce pass inside to Reynolds. Back out to Boggs, top of the key to Garner, curling off the screen of the left wing. Bounce pass left block to Rendell, works her way to the paint, scoops it up and good. Nice seal move by Abby Rendell, and it's 23-18.
She has a nice little arsenal of moves, the up and unders, and then she can hit that 15-foot jump shot as well.
She's nice with that drop step.
Yeah.
That's tough to stop with her arm length. Here's DeFries driving baseline. Rendell blocked it. That helps side defense on the rotation. And here comes William & Mary. Boggs sprinting all the way to the basket. Floats it up. No. Rendell the follow. Banks it through. And we've got a 3-point game again.
Yeah, this has been a nice about minute stretch here for Abby Rendell in general. And a lot of those triple-doubles she's had have been with blocks.
She's got 8 points here already in this one. 6:07 to go. A tough pass, but then a foul as DeFries did a good job to come to the ball, get it, and draw the contact. And that's Boggs' second foul.
Yeah, that's big. That's big for the Tribe, for Boggs to have her second foul.
So she has to sit down. Nyla Pollard returns. She hasn't played since the game's opening minutes. Inbound goes to Gonzalez to DeFreeze on the left wing. Was open for a triple, and then they called an arm bar, a little nickel dimer, and I believe that's Pollard's second. No, they gave the early one. They originally had signaled to Pollard. They switched it off to Garner, so it's only her first. Team's third. And again, it's William and Mary picking up a bunch of fouls early in the quarter.
And it seems like as soon as one of their players substitutes into the game, they pick up a foul or two.
That's not the way that Ed Swanson was hoping this game would unfold. Lawrence with it in the high post, looks opposite wing to Cargo. Left wing give goes to Gonzalez. Back into the corner, nobody was home. Thought maybe there was a sixth player I had lost track of because Gonzalez threw that pass very confidently, but nobody was there. And back to William and Mary it goes.
I'm not sure where that one was headed.
Perhaps you thought Cargo would drift towards that corner. 5:53 left, second period. Delaware 23, William and Mary 20 as their drive bring it up with a little bit of momentum. They trail by as many as 9 here in the early going. Green into the corner to Pollard, lobs it right block to Rendell. She's been the tough matchup, but she throws it away here. Right to Bailey Cargo on the steal. Cargo works it across the timeline, waits and finds Gonzalez. Left wing give to Lawrence, right back to Gonzalez. High post to Anabosi, out to Cargo. Right wing three is short. Offensive board off the fingertips of Rendell, and it'll stay with the Hens as a result.
Yeah, that's a good break there for the Hens because I thought Anabosi actually got a hand on that, but...
I agree. I thought the feed from Gonzalez probably should have went to Cargo for the initial three. By the time Anabosi got it out to her, the defense had gotten out. Garner's got some long arms. She can affect some shots. Here's Gonzalez working it inside the arc. They try to lob it for Anabosi. It's tipped away by Rendell and stolen by William and Mary. Garner feeding it off to Reynolds, who's fouled by West as she went up with a shot. And it'll be two free throws coming for Victoria Reynolds, the sophomore out of Pasadena, California.
Yeah, Carrie West trying to get to the spot, but was obviously still moving and in the restricted area as well.
West picking up a foul, her first, team's first in this second quarter. 5:06 remaining in the opening half. Delaware 23, William and Mary 20. And the lead cut to 2 as Reynolds, a 70% free throw shooter, hits the first. Meanwhile, Chandler Smith enters for the first time, the Port Tobacco, Maryland native, replacing Rendell, who will get a breather. Second free throw, good, and we've got a one-point game.
It really has been a game of runs thus far. Each team doing a good job responding to the other.
Again, full court pressure, not looking to turn Delaware over, but bleeding some clock. Shot clock at 21 as they get into their offense. Lawrence, deep two for the left wing, buries it. Rebecca Lawrence on fire early, hands up three. Three deep two-point jumpers from Rebecca Lawrence in the first 15 minutes. Reynolds tries to go high-low, and her pass is out of bounds. Off the fingertips of Smith. Turnover gives it to Delaware when we return. Timeout on the floor, 4:39 left to go in the second quarter. Delaware 25, William and Mary 22. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
Bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro. The all-new Terrain. Auto Show Purchase Cash is back. Use it to get $5,000 purchase allowance on a 2018 GMC Terrain model when you finance through GM Financial.
I just picked up the cake for the baby shower.
Yay!
You know she's having a boy, right?
Oh boy.
Buick now has an SUV for that. Introducing the Buick Encore.
I knew I could trust you guys with the cake.
No problem. That was close.
One of three luxury SUVs from the new Buick. Auto Show Purchase Cash is back. Use it to get $3,500 purchase allowance on every 2018 Encore Preferred model.
Congratulations to Nicole Anabosi, who blocked the 100th shot of her career during the last segment of the game. Delaware Women's Basketball Twitter account has deemed her the Sultan of SWAT. As we resume action, 4:30 to go, second quarter. Delaware 25, William and Mary 22. Abby Gonzalez with the top of the circle. Right wing give to Lawrence, lobs it inside. Anabosi powers up, draws the foul, and will head to the line for repair. As Nicole Anabosi, dealing with a lot of size on the inside, worked her way for two free throws.
You know, we talk so much about her footwork and what she brings underneath the rim, but it's really been since she's been able to go either left or right that it becomes very hard to guard her, and that's where she's really elevated her game.
So the first one goes, one more coming for Anabosi. Line right, hands up four, and can't make it five as the ball goes in and out. 26-22, the advantage. Here comes William and Mary. Green so tricky off the bounce. Cargo all over her. Near wing give goes to Pollard. Pollard up top to Green. Low bounce pass. Kicked by Reynolds, but she got it back. Kicks it right wing over to Garner. Hands it there to Green. Still 11 on the shot clock. Green uses the high screen. Works her way to the free throw line. Out to Garner with 6 to shoot. Hands it back to Green. 4 to shoot. Gets away inside the arc. Gets stuck. Has to fire one off balance up. An air ball and a shot clock violation. 30 seconds of fantastic defense from Delaware.
Yeah, Jenna Green really having a tough night tonight. This is one of the poorest games I've seen her play in her 4 years here. Usually so solid, just can't seem to figure things out here against this Blue Hens defense.
Hens paying her a lot of attention on the defensive end. Here's Lawrence, deep two for the right wing. Wouldn't go, weak side rebound, tip, and stolen away by West. And another opportunity coming here for Delaware. Kerry West came out of nowhere.
Well, she tends to do that, doesn't she?
She's so athletic. And has really gotten better at reading the ball this year. Here's an inside touch for Anabosi. Opposite wing look to West. Had an extra feed for Gonzalez. Instead looks opposite wing to Lawrence. Back to West. This time into the corner to Gonzalez. Driving baseline. Out to Cargo. Extra feed in the corner. Lawrence. Jumper. Good. Great ball movement from Delaware. Hands up six.
Yeah, that's how you get everybody to touch the ball. You use the shot clock. Fantastic ball movement by the Hens.
And another deep two from Rebecca Lawrence. She's knocked down four of at least 18 feet. Reynolds with it in the high post, dribbling it off the foot of Anabosi. It'll go out of bounds, and it'll stay with William and Mary.
It seems like she has more than 8 points, doesn't it? It just feels that way.
She's made timely jumpers, that's for sure. Rendell returns. Libby Underwood in for the first time for the try. Rendell has been a real problem for Delaware on the offensive end. The inbound goes to Green, top of the key. Green seems to be dribbling aimlessly. Gives it off to Garner, right wing triple. Good. Garner, quick release, and it's back to a three-point game.
Yeah, William and Mary has done a nice job of hitting those big shots as well to kind of stop the Hens from creating too much space.
Well, you can't even blink on Nari Garner. She's getting that shot up in a hurry. Cargo on the left wing. Dribbles towards the top, picks up her bounce, feeds to the corner, far side to West. Back up top to Cargo. Entry feed to the high post to Anabosi. Up and under move on Reynolds. Swats it off the window and grabs the rebound. Gives it up to Green to bring it forward.
Yeah, Anabosi didn't have her feet under her for that one.
Underwood open three near corner. Front rim, no. Rebound to West. In traffic, ripped it away. Three on two if she hurries. Carey all the way. Can't get the shot, but she is fouled. And will hit the line for a pair.
Kerry West so often sacrifices her body, not only on the defensive end, but on the offensive end. I was kind of cringing because I was waiting for her to hit the ground and, slam her body into the defense and go down. She did a good job of staying on her feet there.
She'll get two free throws as a result. Senior out of Coram, New York. Hens up three, 1:56 to go. That was the second foul on Jenna Green. First free throw, good. One more coming for West. So now we've seen two fouls on Bianca Boggs, their leading scorer. Now two fouls on their point guard and floor general, Jenna Green. And we'll see Nicole Anabosi sit down for the first time. She is replaced by Lizzie O'Leary. One more foul shot for West, line right, and that one is good. So it's 30-25, Delaware.
And when I say I cringe when she was going out, not because of the taking the shot, because
I
always
cringe.
Yes, I always, it hurts my back when she falls.
Garner, open triple, deep off the window for the right wing. Rebound grab by Cargo. Here comes Delaware. Gonzalez gets it set, top of the key, gives it right wing to Cargo. Cargo lobs it right elbow to O'Leary. High-low, give to Lawrence, lays it in with a left hand.
Great seal there by Rebecca Lawrence, a nice use of the left.
And Delaware's up 7 as a result. Rebecca Lawrence has 10 in the first half. Underwood the other way, threw it away right to O'Leary.
Ed Swanson is beside himself right now. I think he's trying to figure out what his team is doing.
Arms folded, biting the lip, just trying to make it to halftime. Lawrence in the corner, gives it to O'Leary, driving to the basket, gets the roll, she lays it in.
I love how these bigs are all going off the dribble right to the rim. What a take by O'Leary.
And a high-low set it up because Lawrence cut to the basket. Two defenders went with her, opening the path for O'Leary. Up top, it's Reynolds driving on West, kicked it out to Underwood. Underwood wouldn't take the shot. Gives it to Green, up top to Garner, lobbing it. It's tipped away by Lawrence, stolen by O'Leary, but she walked. And she knew it, and she dragged the pivot to try to find a point guard, Abby Gonzalez.
And Coach Natasha Adair clapping and shaking her head. Don't worry. See, she doesn't mind that because she the hustle play, and, you know, that just happened. She's encouraging her.
An air of effort you can live with, though.
Yep.
The inbound will come with 40 seconds left of the half. A fresh 30 for William and Mary. They get it into Reynolds on the left block. Reynolds powers up on Lawrence. Lawrence blocked the shot. And it goes to West, 6 second differential, shot and game clock.
The duo of O'Leary and Lawrence right now are just playing fantastic minutes.
A sophomore and a freshman going to be here for a while. Up top, it's Lawrence, fires the triple. Can't get the roll. Boy, that was a heat check. Rebound grabbed by Pollard. Pollard brings it up. They can hold for one. Green recognizes it and will slow it up.
Yeah, O'Leary had her on the CL too, wide open.
Green works her way to the foul line, into the corner. Pollard hesitates, fires the triple, off the mark. O'Leary the rebound, 2 seconds to go. Gonzalez a three-quarter court heave, only goes half the length of the floor, and it'll roll to the baseline at the end of the first half. And a good close for Delaware as the Hens have a game-high 9-point lead in intermission. Pretty good stuff there from Delaware, especially on the defensive end.
Yeah, again, I thought they did a great job when William and Mary started to make their run. Delaware did a great job responding, but it was on the defensive end. Steals by the bigs, hands in the passing lane, except for that last miss on the closeout, which didn't matter anyway because he didn't make the shot. Delaware's defense really propelling them to this 9-point lead.
34-25 at the break. We'll take a break when we return. Ronnie Vickers back at our Newcastle studios. We'll have the halftime report.
Calling all creators.
Those with the need
to make something new.
Who are obsessed with progress.
Creativity is everything in today's game.
It's about making a statement.
I think what we're all trying to do is leave a mark so the game will never be the same.
The game will never
be the same.
We're all creators.
Related by a mindset.
That's our job, to continue to try to enlighten while we inspire.
I've been taking example of it. But now I have to create for myself.
It's not about borders,
gender,
a race.
I ain't trying to stay in my lane. I'm trying to strike while the iron hot.
It's all intertwined. Fashion inspires music.
Music, art, design, and sport together.
Come on, Hopkins. You know you listening to Pusha T before you hit the field. And Aaron Rodgers, maybe you should.
Join us.
Pull up a chair.
Let's change sport. Let's
change lives.
Let's create.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing, maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously, or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Once it into the post, Nick Harrison.
We've all been there.
Can't even see the score.
Oh my God.
Trying to watch the game on that tiny screen. It's time to watch sports the way they were meant to be watched. On this, in high definition, you can now watch all your favorite teams and players on the big screen for free. With CAA.TV, you'll never miss a moment. Take back the living room by searching CAA on your device.
Bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro. The all-new Terrain. Auto Show Purchase Cash is back. Use it to get $5,000 purchase allowance on a 2018 GMC Terrain model when you finance through GM Financial.
I just picked up the cake for the baby shower.
Yay!
You know she's having a boy, right?
Oh boy.
Buick now has an SUV for that. Introducing the Buick Encore.
I knew I could trust you guys with the cake.
Oh, no problem. That was close.
one of three luxury SUVs from the new Buick. Auto Show Purchase Cash is back. Use it to get $3,500 purchase allowance on every 2018 Encore Preferred model.
During halftime, and boy, did the Vado boys impress.
Well, you know, the little crew of the four boys come to almost every home game. They're a great bunch of little boys, Drew, Trent, Emmett, and Nicholas. And the youngest one, Trent Mata, the baby of the group, gamer coming up clutch, winning musical chairs.
Smoked everybody, had to make a layup, grab his seat when the music stopped. He did it three times. He's the winner, and I don't think he'll sit down for the rest of the night. 11 o'clock bedtime for Trent.
Hey now.
Up nine at the break is Delaware as the Hens shooting 43% in that first half. They knock out three of their 10 threes, but a lot of deep twos, especially from Rebecca Lawrence, who had 10 points, two boards, an assist, a block in 14 minutes. And the Cornabosi having a hard time getting going offensively, but six rebounds, two assists, two blocks, and a steal, so finding other ways to be involved.
Well, you know, all the attention that's being drawn to Nicole Anabosi, that's what's opening things up for Rebecca Lawrence, for Lizzie O'Leary, and the bigs are playing great high-low. They're doing a good job of shaping up and posting up and getting some good looks, but it's those perimeter shots, whether they're threes or long twos, that are opening up those looks on the inside. It just balances everything out.
And Delaware doing a good job on the glass. They're plus three, 22 to 19. And as a result, the Hens up by nine, joined now by assistant coach Michaela Walker. And at the half, coach, had to be really pleased with how aggressive your team was on the offensive end. We saw some open jumpers, and they didn't shy away, especially Rebecca Lawrence, huh?
Yeah, actually, that's been something that we've actually really been focusing on in the last couple of weeks. Everybody's got to be a scoring option, and that's something that Rebecca's been working on all season. She's really been working on her jump shot, so it's really great to see it falling and see her shooting in confidence.
And Lizzie O'Leary coming in, giving some great minutes for you guys in that first half.
Absolutely. I can't tell you enough how excited I am, because these are things that we've been working on all week. Literally, everybody's got to be a scoring option, and they're looking to score, so this is what we need out of them.
How about on the defensive end? What's been the key? I mean, that's a good offense that you held to 25 points and really tough shooting percentage.
Yeah, I think our communication has been the key. Another thing that we've really locked in on is being communicating on defense the entire time, the entire possession for the whole 30 seconds. They got to keep talking. So we've been working on that, and it's just been great to sit on the sidelines and see it manifest like this.
Nice when the kids follow the game plan. Good luck
in the second half.
Thank
you.
Michaela Walker as Delaware up 34 to 25 at the break. We mentioned the defensive prowess from Delaware. The numbers back it up. 27% from the field, 25% from three. This is an excellent shooting William & Mary team that Delaware has stifled really every stretch of this first half.
Well, I think they came out so strong and they pressured them so great, making them rush certain shots that when they were getting some open looks, they weren't able to knock them down. But again, the defense, even when Delaware has a miscue, they're able to help and recover.
It'll be William & Mary ball to start the second half. Travel go from left to right, 35-24, the Delaware lead. Green gets the inbound for the Tribe. Delaware with the starters on the floor. William & Mary has its starting five on the floor as well. Boggs back in, playing with two. Green also with two fouls for William & Mary. Reynolds has it top of the key, hands it to Green, works her way to the free throw line. Out to Pollard on the right wing. Pollard, low feet for Boggs. Good catch, but she has to back it out near center court. Gets reset, works her way towards the paint, floats one up, no good off the glass. Lawrence clears the rebound for Delaware. Outlets it up to Gonzalez, sprints ahead, stops on the far wing, feeds it off to Cargo, and Cargo will get things set up to Gonzalez.
That was great help side defense by Nicole and Abosi on the other end.
Yeah, and Abosi made it a tough angle, and that's what allowed Lawrence to come over and get an uncontested rebound because of the tough shot. Here's Gonzalez into the corner to DeFreeze, driving baseline, pull-up jumper, can't get the roll, and Abosi fights for the rebound, but Boggs able to rip it clear. Outlets it up to Green on the run. Green works her way towards the paint, got bumped and fouled by Delaware as the reach-in foul committed by Simone DeFreeze. That'll be the first team foul on Delaware. Actually, Bailey Cargo, I beg your pardon, came over and committed the foul. Her first, team's first.
Yeah, she kind of did a little swipe there again. I thought Green was a little out of control, though.
The inbound goes to Reynolds. A flat-footed block shot from Anabosi.
She swatted that with two hands right to the ground. My goodness.
Without jumping. Talk about some anticipation of the shot going up. Anabosi now working the other way, couldn't get established, and Reynolds stole the pass from Cargo, and here comes William & Mary.
Little helter-skelter pace right now. You want to see which team might try to slow it down and get in their offensive set.
Anabosi denying Rendell in the post. You had Lawrence playing behind her. Anabosi comes in, swats it to the baseline. Well, this is eerily similar to what we saw at the start of the game as neither team scored for more than 2 minutes. We're minute 25 in without a bucket to start the second half. Green will try to change that. Runner in the lane, no good. Anabosi the rebound for Delaware.
Anabosi has just been all over the glass here tonight.
Gonzalez across the timeline, off to Lawrence on the left wing. Good catch in traffic, gives it inside to Anabosi on the left block. Doubled, now tripled, still powers up and draws the contact from Abby Rendell. Good patience there from Anabosi. The defense took its time, inching towards her, and left a little avenue for her to split.
She looked over her left shoulder, felt the defender. Help was actually coming in on that other side, but she was able to pivot around and go under and then absorb that contact. Just great patience and footwork by Anabosi.
When they get it to her in that position, too, she can go left, she can go right, and it's hard for the defense, it almost feels like, to figure out which way to bring the double from.
Yeah, but it's really been, you know, what's evolved for her is her patience. She's not panicking, and if I don't have the shot, I got to get it out. She's taking her time and letting herself feel that defense.
First free throw, no good. She'll get one more. 8:15 left, third quarter. She buries the second. And the first double-digit lead of the game belongs to Delaware, 35-25. As a matter of fact, William & Mary has never led in this game. Boggs works it into the forecourt for the Tribe. Dishes out to Reynolds, right wing to Green. Inside touch for Rendell, backing down Anabosi. Got it, plus the foul. Lefty scoop as Anabosi guessed wrong, trying to block the bigger player. And Rendell to the line for the old-fashioned three-point play.
And she knew it right away. She brought that right arm down like a hammer and went right across her arms.
You kind of have to guess a little bit when you're playing somebody who you're giving up 4 inches on. And if you get a little fake, as Rendell gave her, sometimes you're going to pick up a foul, but Rendell can't make her pay. Misses the free throw. Lawrence the rebound. Two fouls on Anabosi, two team fouls on Delaware. Hens ball up 8, 7:53 to go in the third. Anabosi swings it right wing to Cargo. Bounce pass to the corner to DeFries. DeFries back to Cargo. Up top, Gonzalez into the corner. Anabosi deep two. Got it! Showing a range. A 17-footer. Delaware back up 10.
That's just a great decision by Nicole Anabosi. You know, she's having a little bit of a hard time getting that ball inside consistently. And then she also has to pull out this defender and make a player honest. Oh, watch out for the rest of the game.
Garner came in at the last whistle. Open corner, Jay, no good. Offensive rebound, Reynolds. Her follow off the mark. Anabosi the rebound up to Gonzalez. Outlets it ahead to Cargo. Got stuck in the air, couldn't hit the shot, but the rebound tipped out to his center court. And Gonzalez, Johnny on the spot, taking another try for Delaware.
Yeah, Cargo just finding herself too far underneath the basket and really had nowhere to go with it.
Cargo foul line right. Bounce pass up top to Gonzalez. Back to Bailey Cargo. Cargo lobs it right elbow to Anabosi. Driving on Rendell. Blocked on the way up. Anabosi sticks with it. Pulls it free. Up and under move. Floats it. Wouldn't go. And a shot clock violation as she missed the rim. She came so open. I think she surprised herself and missed the shot as a result.
Well, what persistence and what raw strength. She ripped that ball out of her hands and went up with it. Wow, she is so strong.
6 3/4 minutes remaining in the third period. Delaware up by 10. Green, some fancy dribble work, but goes nowhere. Off the Garner on the right wing. Gives it in the corner to Boggs, driving baseline. Denied by DeFries, but finds Rendell for the layup. Abby Rendell so active without the ball today.
She's really deceptive because, you know, when you kind of watch her run up and down the floor, you don't realize what a great tool set she has underneath the rim.
Here's Anabosi powering her way to the basket, threw it over the backboard. Out of bounds, it'll go to William & Mary.
And I think she's wondering how, you know, the contact didn't create that, have a nice little conversation with the referee. And
oh, they're going to overturn it.
They're going to say it was tipped. I think that's what Nicole Anabosi was saying as well. She's like, I didn't just throw it up at the shot clock.
I think your first indication was right. I think it was one of those deals where the official didn't want to call the foul, so no call, but when the ball goes up over the backboard, you kind of call something. She's not going to just play peg with the shot clock. So the call goes against it. Swanson into DeFries, plus the foul as she powered it up with a left hand.
Now talk about raw strength of Nicole Anabosi. How about that by Simone DeFries? She said, oh yeah, I can get my weights up too. Watch this.
Wow. That ball almost got tied up as she caught a low feed around her knee. And as she powered it up, just won the battle and then drew the contact. And now the free throw off the mark, but Cargo the offensive board.
And the way it went off the backboard and in almost felt like a pinball machine.
Ends by 10 with possession. Cargo into the lane, out to Gonzalez. doubled, feeded it back to Cargo, deep two, good! Billy Cargo gives Delaware the dozen-point advantage.
Yeah, if you're the Tribe, you do not want to give the Hens second and third chance points.
5:54 to go in the third quarter, only 4 points since halftime for William and Mary. Far wing, it's Garner now driving baseline, pull-up jumper around and out. Rebound, though, Reynolds out to Green, foul line jumper, that one's good. Too many chances, and the Tribe back to within 10. Again, this dummy pressure from William and Mary just has not sped Delaware up, although I jinxed him a little bit here. Gonzalez stuck in the backcourt, just got it across with about a half second to spare, finding Cargo. Back to Gonzalez, attacks the paint, kicks it out to DeFreeze, tried to drive baseline, turned back, so finds Gonzalez inside touch, Anabosi, opposite corner to Cargo, can't get the roll on the jumper, and Bogged the rebound amongst the trees. Outlets it up to Green on the run. Green shake and bake move, works her way to the paint, got tripped and fouled by Gonzalez.
You know, I do think that when Ed Swanson went to starting to mix up those defenses, went from the man-to-man into that zone, it has disrupted the flow a little bit. But great recognition on that offensive end by Nicole Anabosi. Even though Cargo missed that second shot, she knew she was hot and she had hit that last shot and got it right to her immediately.
Inbound baseline right will come from Green. Green finding Garner, foul line left. Garner dribbles towards the top, leaves it there for Bailey Eichner. Eichner right wing to Boggs, who's been quiet. Boggs spins her way to the paint, has to kick it out to Green. Up top to Eichner. Eichner back to Green, 17 to shoot. They're fronting Rendell in the post. Green has to work it herself behind the back of the bounce, leaves it off for Boggs. Boggs got by DeFreeze, laid it in, tough finish by Bianca Bob.
That was a great take. Great, powerful take by Boggs.
41-33. That was good possession defensively from Delaware. And then Cargo gets fouled. A silly one from Eichner out near his center court. That'll be Hens ball when we return. Timeout on the floor. 4:33 left to go in the third quarter. Delaware 41, William & Mary 33. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV.
The official bird of Delaware isn't red. It's not green or purple. It's blue. Coincidence? We think not. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield, Delaware. This blue hen does not need to see a podiatrist. But if he did, waiting for a referral might get his feathers in a bunch. And he wouldn't like that one bit. Highmark Blue Cross Blue Shield, Delaware.
Hi guys, it's great to be here.
In the desert.
At the mall.
On the mountain.
At school.
At the beach.
In the Big Easy.
Yeah.
Today I want to show you guys the next gen Chevy Equinox. What do you think?
That's pretty.
Pretty sexy.
It's all wheel drive, look at that.
It looks aggressive.
But not overbearing.
It's not too big, not too small.
Looks like it could go off-roading.
But at the same time, it looks like a car you could take to a nice event.
You can dress it up or dress it down.
Seems like the perfect car for anybody.
I would take it anywhere.
I want one.
I love it.
She's a bad mamma jamma.
Chevy stepped their game up.
Center 4:33 to go in the third quarter. Delaware 41 and William & Mary 33. Each team has made a little run here to start the second half. Hens have been pretty solid on the defensive end. A little bit of a struggle though in the third quarter on the offensive side. William & Mary doing a pretty good job trying to deny Anabosi And they've really taken her away. West with it on the perimeter, in for Delaware, up top to Lawrence. Lawrence giving it high post to Anabosi, looks opposite corner. Gonzalez can't get the roll on the baseline jumper. Rendell the rebound, stripped by West, but Boggs swoops in to grab it. And here comes William Mary on the run. Garner into the forecourt, hits a trailing Boggs. She'll get organized, finding Green, the point guard. Green swings it left wing to Garner. Garner up top to Eichner. Eichner, right wing feed over to Green. Green was trying to get it inside to Rendell, and Rendell was held away from the ball. Lawrence bumping her on the cut. Actually, Anabosi bumping her on the cut.
That's huge.
That's her third as a result. I really thought that was going to be caught on Rebecca. Third foul, fourth team foul. So William and Mary will shoot the final 4 minutes of the quarter. Green inbounds it. Reynolds right back to Green, who dribbles towards the top of the key. Green now left the lane, darts past the defense, lays it in. Beautiful take again from Jenna Green.
That's the Jenna Green we're used to seeing. That's what she does. She attacks those defenses.
Gonzalez threw it away. Too high for Anabosi. Steal by Boggs. Boggs works her way to the paint, finds Reynolds. Got it, and a foul. And just like that, a free throw away from making this a one-possession game is William and Mary.
You have to wonder if Natasha Adair might take a timeout here to talk about it. And she does.
And
not surprised.
So the Hens will take the timeout. We'll take it with Natasha Adair, 3:35 left in the third quarter. Delaware 41, William & Mary 37. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 at 1410 WDOV.
This is what it sounds like when you...
Whether you're a morning person or simply it's not your thing. Maybe you're the type that doesn't take it that seriously. Or you're that person who just makes everyone's morning brighter. There's a McDonald's for every morning.
Enjoy a sausage burrito for $1 or a sausage McGriddle sandwich for $2. Pair it with any size freshly brewed McCafe hot coffee for $1.
Oh, say can you see 2 million bucks?
Watto America is the new drawing game that's sweeping the nation. Get six numbers right, including the star ball, and you win. And with jackpots starting at $2 million, you win big. Lotto America from the Delaware Lottery. It's the new way to play and win the American dream.
Bigger doesn't mean stronger. Don't be defined by a weight class. Introducing the all-new Terrain, the compact SUV from GMC. Mighty like a pro. The all-new Terrain. Auto Show Purchase Cash is back. Use it to get $5,000 purchase allowance on a 2018 GMC Terrain model when you finance through GM Financial.
I just picked up the cake for the baby shower.
Yay! You know she's having a boy, right?
Oh boy.
Buick now has an SUV for that. Introducing the Buick Encore.
I knew I could trust you guys with the cake.
Oh, no problem. That was close.
One of three luxury SUVs from the new Buick. Auto Show Purchase Cash is back. Use it to get $3,500 purchase allowance on every 2018 Encore Preferred model.
Starting to tilt against the Hens a little bit right now. Their once double-digit lead has been trimmed to four, and a free throw coming for Victoria Reynolds. 41-37, Delaware up, 3:35 to go in the third quarter. How do the Hens get momentum back?
Well, I think they need to take care of the basketball. They had been throughout most of the game, and then a bunch of turnovers, and then those turnovers turning into tried points.
11 giveaways now in the game for Delaware. Free throw good for Reynolds, and it is a one-possession game, 41-38.
And now the Tribe being a little more aggressive with this three-quarter court defense.
Yeah, went from dummy pressure to legit pressure, although the Hens able to work it across this time. Gonzalez has it top of the key. Left wing give to Cargo. Cargo towards the top. Finds West. Swing it right wing to Gonzalez. Into the corner, Anabosi up top to Cargo. Left wing give to West. High post to Lawrence. Jumper good. 15-footer. Rebecca Lawrence has 12. Delaware's up 5.
And she was such a spark in the first half, having a career first half at those 10 big points.
Boggs the other way, works her way towards the paint, into the lane, floats it up, gets the roll. Bianca Boggs putting on a show off the bounce, and it's back to a three-point game.
It really is impressive. A quick first step and right to the rim.
Was saddled with foul trouble, missed much of the first half as a result. Gonzalez tried to lob it to West against the zone. It's tipped out of bounds on the quickness of Nari Garner. It'll stay with Delaware 18 to shoot.
You got to dribble that over. That's not a good angle there. You can't make that pass. You have to bring it over.
Gonzalez gets the inbound top of the key. Hands it there to Lawrence. Lob it right block. Adebosi seals and banks it in. Awkward footwork, but it laid off or paid off, and it's 45-40.
Yeah, Gabby Rogers just not able to handle Nicole Adebosi down there.
There's Garner, foul line left, looking inside. Instead goes out into the corner and dishes it off to Boggs. Her jumper off the mark, but the follow banks in from Gabby Rogers at his 45-42.
Just no rebounding there. Actually, on the strong side there, nobody got a body on Rogers.
Adebosi with it in the forecourt. Ooh. Rogers, forearms her in the face, and they call a tie-up.
I don't understand that at all. Even Rogers was like, oh my goodness.
She was like, sorry. She was about ready to apologize to the officials. I'm surprised they didn't go to the monitor.
Exactly.
It was not intentional.
No,
but normally, contact above the shoulder doesn't really matter.
That's unbelievable right there.
Crowd at the bottom not happy about it, but we play on. The arrow belongs to Delaware. Inbound goes to Lawrence. In entry feet on the baseline goes to Adebosi. Powers up, got it blocked, but a makeup call.
Yep.
That's a foul on Rendell, even though it looked like she got mostly ball.
And that's exactly what it was. That was a makeup call, and Abby Rendell getting the bad end of that one.
Rendell, only her second foul. Both teams will shoot the rest of the quarter. And two free throws coming for Nicole Adebosi. Line left, first one, I think your part is good. She'll get one more.
Nicole Adebosi, did you see the look in her eyes when she took that ball to the basket? She went with an intense purpose.
And we have seen from Adebosi plenty of intensity over the course of her career. Makes the second shot, 47-42.
She's such a nice young woman. It's wonderful, but boy, don't get her mad on the court.
Yeah, we've talked about it before. It's like there's two Adebosi.
Yep.
There's Boggs on the left wing. Boggs trying to work her way past Gonzalez, can't do it. And then a lob was thrown to no one, but good hustle by Reynolds to chase it down. To Green, top of the circle, 9 to shoot. Green, a step back, can't get free for the jumper. Dishes it off to Garner, open, Trey, good. And it's 47-45.
And Delaware just completely overloaded and then sinking too low, and no one there again for that closeout on the weak side.
Well, the Hens have led the entire game, but the advantage down to two here. West works her way to the paint, got a reach and foul on her way to the basket. Did they count that?
Wow. Oh, my.
Count the bucket for Kiri West.
Look at Ed Swanson. My goodness. And I mean, he has every right. That's the same referee who made the jump ball call with the call.
I don't think that would have counted in the NBA.
No, she caught it. And then Kiri took two more steps.
The official,
her
fellow official came over to ask her about it. Oh. She said, no, count it. And he just shrugged his shoulders like, if you say so.
And now
here's
Ed Swanson now. He's like, you've got to be kidding me. He's like, I'll show you on film. I'll text you the video of that one.
That one, the official's doing the best they can. It's a hard job for sure, but that was not a good one.
Oh, everybody makes mistakes, players, coaches, and the referees as well.
Announcers. West misses a second free throw. I made 11 in the third quarter alone.
Hey, I can't even read my own writing on the keys to the game. You know what I mean?
Lead is 4 for Delaware. Final minute of this third quarter. Box again off the shake and bake. Works her way to the paint. Kicked out to Underwood. Underwood dribbles to the foul. I had it stolen by Adebosi. Swatted it 4. Chased it down. Racing to the bucket. Lays it up but couldn't get the roll. But was fouled and will head to the line to shoot 2. Well, that would have been play of the year had she finished that one.
Well, even just the way she was able to tap that ball to herself, keep that dribble, and then almost completing the play. But the problem for Ed Swanson and his crew is that was actually a really big change there for Kiri West, because that increased the lead from 2-4.
Absolutely, and she missed the first free throw. Who knows what she would have done on the second had it come. Pollard returns, Underwood out, as Adebosi connects on the first, trying to extend what is a 5-point advantage for Delaware. She does not, can't get the roll. Delaware's got to make some free throws here. Reynolds the rebound.
And it's been a struggle at times throughout the season where Delaware's gotten to the line, but just leaving too many points there.
Hens have missed six so far today. Box, step back, triple, left wing, can't get it to go. Anabosi the rebound. Shot clock is off. Final half minute of the third quarter. Anabosi brings it forward. Dishes corner to Cargo. Good job to look up at the shot clock and kick it back out to Gonzalez. She'll whip it back inside. Anabosi spins her way on Rendell. Can't get the roll. West the follow. Blocked by Rendell. And it'll stay with the Hens. Delaware refuses to hold for one in the final half minute. They stay in attack mode. We have seen it all year long. The inbound goes to West up top, almost stumbles, keeps her footing, dishes off to Lawrence, 7 seconds left. Lawrence gives it to Gonzalez, 4 seconds left. Unorganized possession here. Gonzalez, though, draws the nickel dimer. A hand check call will send Gonzalez to the free throw line with 1.4 left of the third, a flat out gift.
And Swanson again having another conversation with the same official. Just, you've got to be kidding me, he's saying. How are you going to call that with 1.4?
Gonzalez buries the first free throw. One more to go.
He's so animated on the sideline. Such a great guy, Ed Swanson.
He's dying inside right now, and I can see why. Second free throw, no good. And that is the end of the third quarter. The Hens had a double-digit lead. It was cut to as small as 2. It is 6 as we head to the final quarter. Delaware 51, William & Mary 45. You're listening to Blue Hens Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290, 1410 WDOV.
Calling all creators.
Those with the need
to make something new.
Who are obsessed with progress.
Creativity is everything in today's game.
It's about making a statement.
I think what we're all trying to do is leave a mark so the game will never be the same.
The game will never
be the same.
We're all creators.
Related by a mindset.
That's our job, to continue to try to enlighten while we inspire.
I've been taking the example of it, but now I have to create for myself.
It's not about borders,
gender,
or race.
I ain't trying to stay in my lane. I'm trying to strike while the iron hot.
It's all intertwined. Fashion inspires music.
Music, art, design, and sport together.
Come on, Hopkins. You know you listen to Pusha T before you hit the field. And Aaron Rodgers, maybe you should.
Join us.
Pull up a chair.
Let's change sport. Let's
change lives.
Let's create.
To the third quarter, a rare third quarter where Delaware outscored by an opponent 20-17. Could have been worse though for the Hens. They had a double-digit lead that was cut to as narrow as 2. Hens have never trailed. They led by as many as 12 in that third quarter. 51-45 as we start the fourth. William & Mary ball.
Yeah, so many things going in Delaware's favor, and they've gotten to the free throw line 12 more times than the Tribe.
But they have missed 6 of their 18 tries. Here's Boggs driving to the basket and laying it in as she attacked Kiri West and Abby Gonzalez.
Yeah, she's having a heck of a game here.
51-47, 20 seconds into the fourth quarter. Anabosi has it high post from Gonzalez. Right back to Abby. Her feed for Anabosi, too high, but a foul. as Anabosi got shoved by Randall. Now that one was a good call. Anabosi leapt to try to catch it and almost ended up in our lap, and she was standing about on the block, 20 feet from us.
Yes, I would say she was displaced.
Inbound goes to O'Leary out near center court. Lizzie hands it to Gonzalez. Gonzalez turns the corner, pull-up jumper from the foul line, short. Boggs the rebound. Here comes Bianca Boggs, 3-on-2 if she hurries. Boggs wants to go herself into Gonzalez. No good. Randall follows, banks it in, and it's a two-point game again.
Was a good no-call on the original shot, though, I thought.
Absolutely. Gonzalez got there. But as we talked about earlier, you don't have to call a block or a charge. Sometimes you play off. Anabosi with the top of the key. Nice feed inside to O'Leary. Head fake. Still got it blocked by Randall. She is so long inside.
I mean, this is the most consistent William & Mary has played throughout the game, I'd say over the last 5 minutes or so, and now into the fourth quarter.
Three would give them their first lead of the game. Pollard has the top of the key. Dribbles towards the far wing. Up top to Boggs. Boggs dribbling out near center court, wants to attack. High screen from Randall, works away to the paint. Out to Garner for the lead. Can't hit the three. Long rebound. Pollard had it knocked free by Gonzalez, and Abby ends up with it for Delaware.
Yeah, that was a great rundown by Abby Gonzalez. The way she was able to keep that dribble, too, to keep it in bounds.
DeFries near wing entry feed to a cutting Anabosi, spinning to the bucket, banking it in high off the window.
Nicole Anabosi. Just her. I love the spin move. I love the footwork. I love the strength.
Kind of making it up as she goes along amongst all types of traffic. Boggs the other way. What a move. Finding Reynolds for the layup.
And no weak side rotation there. Abby Gonzalez never dropped on that weak side.
53-51. Teams trading buckets now. Gonzalez in the forecourt for Delaware looking for another response. Directing traffic, all kinds of disorganization here. Late coming up was O'Leary. Inside to Anabosi, powers up with the left hand, too strong, and then a foul on the rebound. Boggs grabbed it, and DeFries reached in on her. And they give the foul, actually to Kiri West. It'll be her second, team's first in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, things started to get a little more physical here in the fourth quarter for both teams.
I think some fatigue setting in a little bit as well. It's been playing at a pretty high rate, despite the fact that it's just 53-51 in the fourth quarter. So William & Mary going to slow it up again. A three to take the lead, a two to tie. Boggs has been lethal off the bounce. High post give to Rendell on the left elbow. Left wing to Garner, driving on Cargo, scoops it up and in. We are tied at 53, 7:20 to go in the fourth.
Oh, balanced scoring for the Tribe. I mean, different players stepping up throughout the game.
This is an important possession. Cargo between the rings, picking up her bounce. Gonzalez comes to the ball. Right elbow to Anabosi, out to O'Leary. Buries the jumper. 55-53, the freshman Lizzie O'Leary.
See, what's great is the confidence this coaching staff instills in these players. For Lizzie O'Leary, a freshman big, to shoot that long shot at that point of the game and nail it. What does that tell you?
Such a good point. Randall in the high post, out to Boggs. Boggs working her way along the baseline, back to Randall for the layup.
This is becoming some pretty basketball here. Great plays by both teams.
Textbook two-man game from William & Mary.
And we've seen that throughout with multiple combinations.
That time along the baseline, 55-55, DeFries in the corner. Entry feed to Anabosi, looks opposite wing, Cargo, big triple, got it! Barely, Cargo heads back up three.
I knew before that even hit her hands for the catch that was going in.
You did the Jay Wright bang.
That's
as
right.
It was in the air.
I wish you could see me because I gave it a boom.
You rung it up. Here's Boggs on the left wing, high post to Randall, up top. Finds Rogers. Rogers hands it back to Boggs. Boggs turns the corner. Boggs missed the layup. O'Leary may have altered it. And then a foul on Rogers. What a rate she has had tonight. Seconds to fouls, maybe on the verge of setting a record. Had they called that foul earlier that was ruled a jump ball, she picks up three here. Could have been four. She has played less than a minute and a half.
I'll tell you what, with the physicality of the game kind of increasing here, this may come down to free throws at the end of the game.
58-55, Delaware by three. Anabosi attacking with a left hand, can't get it to go. Rebound batted right back to her, but she was on the baseline. And a ball back to William & Mary as a result.
Yeah, Anabosi never reestablishing her position inbounds.
little bit of a force there, something we have not said very often this year from Anna Bowles.
Yeah, she kind of lost it going up in that left hand. I mean, I thought it was an okay drive. I think she just kind of lost it going up.
5 3/4 minutes remaining. Hens up three. William and Mary the ball. Tribe have never led. They tied it a moment ago. Green into the forecourt. Green picks up her bounce. Dishes off to Reynolds. Back to Green. Entry feed to Rendell. Finds a cutting Reynolds. Out to Garner for three. And the tie in and out. Anna Bowles hit a rebound for Delaware.
Wow. Yeah, Delaware has got to correct that here in the last 5 minutes. That weak side closeout. They're sinking too low. That's going to come back to bite them.
DeFreeze up top, gives it near wing to Cargo. Up top to DeFreeze, right wing to Gonzalez. Bounce pass in the corner to Anna Bolsi. Lobbing it up top to DeFreeze, 10 to shoot. Simone back to corner, Gonzalez for three, deep. Anna Bolsi tipped the rebound out of bounds off of Reynolds, and it'll stay with Delaware when we return. Take a deep breath, 4:58 to play, and clinging to a three-point lead, 58-55. You're listening to Delaware Women's Basketball on Fox Sports 1290 and 1410 WDOV. We are still on the air. UD trying to take out our equipment there during that media timeout. 4:58 to go in the fourth quarter. Could be an exciting finish. I'm Matt Janis with Christine Coromata doing her second game of the day, paying through some pain and working well. Zen's trying to grit their way to this victory.
Trying to be a gamer, my friend.
You're working well. Gonzalez gets it into Cargo on the left wing. Cargo dribbles towards the top of the key. Entry feed to Anna Bolsi. Double comes out to O'Leary, far corner. Driving baseline back to Anna Bolsi. Point blank jumper, no. DeFreeze, follow good. Delaware up five.
Great persistence by all. Lizzie O'Leary, fantastic pass.
How did she see Anna Bolsi through all that traffic? Here's Garner lobbing in the corner to Rendell. Inside to Reynolds. Double comes back out to Reynolds. Set shot, no good. Weak side rebound, Anna Bolsi, and judging on Ed Swanson's reaction, don't think that was the shot he was looking for.
Nicole Anna Bolsi, 15 points, 15 rebounds. My goodness.
A double, double machine. Near wing, DeFreeze into the corner, O'Leary. Cross court, skip pass, Gonzalez had an open tray, instead inside to Anna Bolsi. Anna Bolsi draws the double out to DeFreeze. Left wing triple. Got it! Simone DeFreeze puts Delaware up eight.
Simone DeFreeze with 5 straight points to create space.
And then a kickball on the entry feed from the active DeFreeze. And what a response here from Delaware. 8 in a row after William & Mary not in the game at 55.
Just a great response to that run by Delaware. My goodness, that's what exactly what winners do.
Can they close it out? 3 3/4 minutes left. Boggs on the near wing. Entry to Rendell, spinning from a double, and a foul called against Delaware.
Oh, I thought she traveled. I mean, I understand the foul call with the two players there, but I thought when she tried to split, she shuffled those feet.
Should be on the floor,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it should be on the floor then if it was during the split.
They're going to say shots.
Well, at first they called that on Nicole Nabosi. Now they just switched it to Simone DeFries.
It's DeFries' first. Team second. Rendell the line. I think the problem was the timing of the whistle as the first free throw was good. I could see the nudge getting called, but when they blew the whistle, she had already established some space between her and the defender, maybe as a result of the nudge. Here's the second free throw good. 63-57, back to a six-point game. They lob the entry to Anabosi. Some traffic around her, dishes off to Cargo. Cargo lobs it forward to O'Leary to Gonzalez, center of the floor, 3:30 to go. Hens up 6, Gonzalez on the near wing. Gonzalez dribbling towards the top to DeFries on the left wing. Lob entry goes to Anabosi. On the far corner, O'Leary, deep 2, back rim, no. Offensive board, DeFries, follow wouldn't go, but she's fouled. And Simone DeFries doing yeoman's work on the glass. Pinna stripe for a pair.
Simone DeFries has just taken over since the 4:58 mark.
And Jenna Green just fouled out of the game.
Wow.
Tough one for her, only 4 points. And she will have to sit down and will be replaced by Gabby Rogers.
You know, as the senior leader, she sat down there. I don't think she can believe what's happened here. I'd be curious to know if she's ever fouled out of a game before.
Free throws here for DeFries. A high arcer swishes through. One more lead restored to 7 for UD.
I've always been so impressed in how silent the Bob can get.
Says the person who doesn't have to talk when it gets that silent. Second free throw, no good.
Ah.
Rogers the rebound. Christine gave me the evil eye, blaming me for throwing the free throw off.
Way to go, Janice.
I don't remember saying air ball. Here comes Boggs working her way to the paint. Nice hold of the pivot. Freed herself up to find Rogers. Back out to Boggs. Driving into a double, contorting shot wouldn't go. O'Leary the rebound for Delaware.
Lizzie O'Leary, what an upside. What an element she brings to this team of toughness, but mobility for a big.
Boy, I thought O'Leary was going to pull the trigger there. Out to DeFries, inside Anabosi, spinning her way to the bucket. Shot wouldn't go, rebound batted around, and Garner swoops in for the rebound. Still time for William & Mary. Down 7, but they got to go. 2:33 left on the clock.
And it is interesting. Even though Jenna Green hasn't had a great game, it's still difficult without your point guard with under 3 to go.
Boggs tried to fire up a 3-pointer off the bounce. It was short by 2 feet. Rendell tried to save it in, but right to Gonzalez.
Just a calmness your senior point guard brings in being able to dribble and get the ball where it needs to go.
And get everybody organized on the offensive end. DeFries threw it away. Tried to lob into a triple team, and there were multiple Tribe defenders there to steal it. Garner the other way. Leaves it for Boggs. Boggs tries to create into the paint. Got fouled on her way to the basket. Should be on the floor. It is. Only the third team foul on Delaware.
Well, you never know. you never know here tonight.
Let's wait until we see them actually throw it in, which they will. But they really went away from Rendell, who was their bread and butter for stretches of that first half and early third quarter.
I mean, she's got 18 points. If I'm William & Mary, I'm isolating her, getting her the basketball, or doing that two-man game again.
Timeout. Ed Swanson as the Tribe were struggling to get it in. This is an important possession. And the Tribe had 4 timeouts left, so they might as well use one here to try to get organized. There is time to go inside. You don't want to grind out 30-second possessions here, but you also don't have to start rushing shots or even playing the perimeter game. You can just run your regular stuff. I know the loss of Green certainly makes it harder, but it just seems like they haven't even given Rendell a chance to post up in the second half.
Yeah, the importance of this possession is because it can cut it to a 2-possession game either way, no matter what kind of shot they make. But I thought that even with the 2-man game, it wasn't always Green running that. You know, Boggs is able to do that. I think Garner could do that as well. But you're right. I mean, you got to go to your senior leader, Rendell.
So, with 2 minutes to go, and a Hens up 7, The inbound will come baseline right from Victoria Reynolds. Reynolds gets it in left wing to Boggs. Boggs dribbling towards the lane. Boggs left it for Reynolds. Too high, stolen by O'Leary. It was there, just a sloppy pass results in a turnover. And the Hens up seven with the ball, but then Anabosi dribbled it off her foot, somehow got it back.
That was Lizzie O'Leary's third steal of this basketball game.
Boy, she has done a nice job off the bench. Here's Cargo leaving for Gonzalez. Left wing triple, no good. Rebound batted high in the air. Anabosi out hustling William and Mary to the loose ball. And then a foul against the Tribe with 1:21 to go. Not a bad idea. 14th foul. You might want to put Delaware on the line, especially with the way the Hens have struggled.
I mean, with that offensive rebound, though, that could be a defining moment in the game.
The inbound will come far sideline, and it's into Gonzalez. Gonzalez out near center court. Abby dribbling between the rings. 1:15 to go. They're going to play it out. DeFries driving towards the corner. Clock is Delaware's friend here. Up three possessions. 1:10 to go. Still 18 on the shot clock. Gonzalez on the right wing. Towards the top of the key. Abby's whips it into the corner to DeFries, drives to the paint. Off-balance runner, no. Rebound batted. DeFries sticks with it. Out of bounds off William and Mary.
Wow.
So now you got a foul. 30 on the shot clock, 57 seconds to go. The officials come in to check that it hit the rim. It did. And the inbound will come baseline left. So now it's a must-foul situation. And the tipped inbound, what do I know, stolen by Boggs. Boggs, great contortion to work her way into the forecourt, all the way to the bucket, bumps into O'Leary, can't get the roll, but he'll head to the free throw line for two.
I applaud the effort there by Lizzie O'Leary, though. I thought she was in good position. I thought she was straight up. I don't think there's much more she could have done there. I thought that was a good play.
Just a little off balance as Boggs changes direction so many times. I think that's what drew the call, but I agree with you. I think she did almost everything she could. Boggs' first free throw, good. She'll get one more. It is a two-possession game. Pollard in. Rogers out. You do have to foul here if you're William Mary. You can go for a steal first, like you got one on the last possession. Then you have to give the contact. Don't want to foul Cargo. Second free throw, good. 64-59. Timeout Delaware to advance the basketball. And the Hens will have two left.
And the biggest thing for Delaware right now is you have to take care of the basketball. You can't have any silly turnovers. Good thing is you get it now on your side of the court. William & Mary's probably not going to play it out totally. They'll probably foul, but you have to take care of the basketball.
Lawrence is a good free throw shooter.
Cargo.
Cargo, obviously, is your best free throw shooter. Gonzalez has been pretty solid. Been up and down for Anabosi and DeFries at the foul line. You have to leave them in because they're your size and they're good in safety outlets catching the basketball. If you're William and Mary, probably got about 3-4 seconds where you go for a quick steal. Then you got to start to put them at the stripe.
Yeah, I think at all costs you get it into Bailey Cargo right away. That's what I would do.
I agree. Teams have certainly tried to deny her the catch this year. I'm sure the draw up was to get Cargo a catch here.
They'll run her off a screen, probably from Anabosi.
Anabosi comes to the ball, gets it, and they foul Anabosi. They were trying to hand it right back to Gonzalez, couldn't quite get it to her in time. And so it's Nicole headed to the stripe for a pair.
And Reynolds wasn't trying to foul her. She's pleaded her case that she didn't try to foul her.
It's her fourth, so she doesn't want to get disqualified, but you got to play the foul game here, so I think that's an end positive gain for William and Mary, but Anabosi hits the first. She's clutch. 65-59, 50 and 1/10 seconds to go. Second, good. 66-59, timeout William and Mary to advance the basketball.
You know, Anabosi, not that she started out a little slow in this game, but Rebecca Lawrence kind of was propelling them early on. Bailey Cargo with a couple big shots, and now look at Bussy now, 17 points, 16 rebounds, just phenomenal.
And has been in the thick of everything defensively, giving up 4 inches inside Abby Rendell. They have done a fantastic job. The trio of Rebecca Lawrence, Nicole Anabosi, and Lizzie O'Leary, three for two, whichever two has been on the floor, have just been all over Rendell in the second half. I thought William and Mary went away from her a little bit, but you have to credit some of it to the Delaware defense.
You know, the way things have played out, you know, Makeda Nicholas hasn't been playing since early in the year, and it opened the door for Lizzie O'Leary, and she's gotten these minutes where maybe she might not have had Makeda Nicholas not gone out, and what valuable minutes for a freshman to get, and look what she's done with them.
The inbound to Garner, her pocket picked by Cargo with the steal. She took it right away from her, wasn't even dribbling, and now they play the foul game as Garner gets the contact, but with 39 and 3/10 to go, Delaware should get out of here with a win.
Yeah, wow, and if I'm Cargo, I'm not letting that ball go. If I'm the best free throw shooter on the team, I'm holding on to that ball. Make him come and get you.
I agree, you want to burn some clock, but I think you'd rather Cargo at the line, although Gonzalo's not bad in her own right, hits the first, lead is 8. And time, a big, big problem for William and Mary now. DeFreeze tried to sneak her way back to the lane. Goose steps in after she thought she might get a lane violation as the official was about to give it to Gonzalez, who buries the second. The lead is 9. Timeout, William and Mary. And now if you're the Tribe, got to start to think about some three-point shots at this point. Twos aren't going to do it.
Yeah, I think that's all you can do. And if Delaware just plays perimeter defense, and if they're man-to-man, you got to come together, shoulder-to-shoulder. If William & Mary tries to weave or tries to hand off, as long as you come together shoulder-to-shoulder, don't let them step behind or do the little pitch, they should be in good shape.
So Delaware up 68-59, trying to get win number 14 on the year, win number 7 in conference play. And another home game coming up this weekend. So as we talked about earlier, a chance to really build some momentum here if you're Natasha Adair's team.
And the biggest thing is in the CAA, you have to get the wins that you can. Because when you come up to the against the upper echelon with the JMUs, which they have not seen them once yet, they still have to play them twice, play Drexel again. You know, you need these wins.
Fox gets the inbound off to Garner. Drop the pass. Chase it down near center court. Good job to keep it in. But valuable time off the clock. Fox gets it. Left wing 3. No. DeFreeze the rebound, and that should do it. William and Mary won't foul. Delaware will be able to dribble out this clock. What a gritty win for UD.
And what a difference at the end of the game for William and Mary trying to get set up into an offense without their senior point guard. They were so discombobulated, just couldn't get set.
And even when she didn't play her best, her presence certainly missed if you're the Tribe. But the clock will run out here as Delaware able to tough out a victory. A tie game, but the Hens end it on an 18-4 run. And as a result, they win 68-59. So, our 13-4 run, I should say. Great math by me. But either way, Delaware improves to 14-8 on the year. 7-4 in conference play. I was an English major, Christine.
Hey, like we said during the game, everybody makes mistakes, Matt.
So, now the Hens will celebrate at center court as the band strikes off the fight song. And, well, that's one of those wins we talked about in the pregame. This was an important game for Delaware, both in the standings, but also for this young team's psyche.
Yeah, for the psyche, and then to propel this homestand that they have coming up.
So Delaware is 7-4 in conference play, and a bunch of happy Blue Hens. And we will take a break. Come back with a post-game show in a moment. Delaware wins it by 9.
It's hard to miss all the TV viewer ads, catches loading surround promises.